Well, hello there. We're back to another random episode of Kingdom Hearts, Melody of Memory. And by random episode, I mean the first episode. Hi, I have no idea when this is going live. I'm recording this the day after the game came out, just because I felt like playing it. And figured I would just hit record and see what happened, right? So, here we go. Also, that opening sound, that was good. Yeah, I was actually going to stream this, but considering that this game came out right during the whole, like, just mute your game audio thing from Twitch. Also, hey, it just goes right in, huh? Okay, we're just going right in. Also, definitely extra bonus. What does that mean? What do I press there? I don't know what to do. I press up, okay. Interesting, I don't think there were those kind of notes in the, So I played the demo, and I don't remember seeing those kind of notes. Oh my gosh, that'd be the best mess with everyone thing entirely if they gave this a similar but subtly different control scheme from the demo. That'd actually be really cool. I would really like that. That'd be hilarious. It'd be hilarious if a game did that. And Kingdom Hearts is definitely one of the games that might. Yep, okay. Yeah, battle enemies. Yeah, that's like the demo. I know how to do this part. I skipped the tutorial. Is that an option? Game? No? Cool. Okay. Makes me actually use the alternative buttons. Oh boy. I always, like, I try and... They don't specify that you have to, but I try and only use X for the middle one just because I think it makes it easier. Thunder. Personally. Circle the... Yeah. This is a Kingdom Hearts game after all. That is, after all, how Kingdom Hearts games work. Oh boy. This is so exciting. I did it. That. Now I've got to play along with the music. I think I can do this. I will say, something I noticed in the demo is that this control scheme feels a little awkward. I don't necessarily know what they could have done to make it better. I'm not saying that, like, oh man, there's so many obvious ways they could have made this better. I just noticed, like, as soon as I started playing, that it felt a little off. That was a little early there. I mean, it was only a little early. I don't know what the game's complaining about. One thing I don't like is that enemies don't evenly come down. Wait, why didn't X work there? What? Like, I hit X and Goofy just kind of didn't attack. He just kind of looked at it like, oh, yeah, there sure is an enemy there. Meanwhile, I'm hitting X and he's like, yeah, that's an enemy. Like, Goofy, please. I'm begging you. Not a little early there. That's better. little slow there. That's the other thing I noticed is depth perception kept getting me in this. And like, you know, that's just the reality of having it on this weird curve instead of straight. Like, it's a cinematic thing. They chose it being cinematic over it being easy to control, which happens. No, I do not want to replay the tutorial. Let me out, please. Let me free. My HP decreases every time I miss. Yep, that's how that works. Okay, thanks. That's all the information I need. Bye-bye. Okay, I've done the tutorial. Oh, hey, whoa, there's a world map. Oh, okay. Okay, so I have to get stars and things. This says progress through world tour. I'm curious what's on the other side of this gate. End of the world, maybe? Some of these I can see what they are, and some of them I can't. This is all Kingdom Hearts 1. Then, probably starting from around here-ish is Chain of Memories, which is its own little side thing, which is cute. Okay, this is cool. I like this. And hey, you can dash just like in the overworld in Kingdom Hearts 2, which is, in my opinion, one of the better ones. Okay, so there's a bunch of different kinds of stars. I have no idea what they mean, but I need different kinds of stars to go places, so let's just start investigating. Okay, so I can get 3 stars for clearing it without items, getting a bunch of points, and getting 70% good or higher. Oh, I bet I know what the different stars are. They're probably for playing it on different things, maybe? I don't know. You know what? I'll find out just by playing, right? Like, that's the best path. Just start playing. I'm really curious to see if they're gonna actually drop any major lore in here. I really hope they do, because it's just such a Kingdom Hearts thing to do. To release a rhythm game and then be like, oh yeah, major lore drop. I have kept myself blind. I haven't looked at anything. So this will be an exciting experience. Like I said, no idea when this will go up on YouTube. Could be in a year. I don't know. You know, I have a lot of things I want to put on YouTube. This is literally getting recorded because I was like, I'm going to play this right now. So it's getting recorded right now. A little early on that. Or a little late. Honestly not sure which one it was. But yeah, they definitely chose being cinematic over graphical clarity. Which means that I probably won't try and, like, get excellent on everything. Because while it's possible to learn all of this, I'm not sure I'm going to take the time to, you know? On the bright side, all the music is really good. I really wonder if they've been planning this since that rhythm mini game and was it? Oh, what game was it in? It was Birth by Sleep, I think? Alright, let's just pretend I hit that enemy up there, yeah? As expected, getting the first 3 stars was pretty easy. I'm pretty sure I got all 3 of them. So, yeah, but that's kind of as expected, right? Like, they're not gonna make that hard. Not yet, anyway. Anyway, yeah, I got an A rank. Okay, so I got some Blazing Shards and Lucid Gems, which implies that I can craft things. And I got something. Some card, maybe? Yeah, new field battle song. Got some items, I guess. I got the team menu. Whatever that is. I guess let's go find out what the team menu is. Yeah, let's go. I really should be doing schoolwork today, but I really want to do this. Okay, yeah, we do that to open stars. Okay. Got it. Let's go find out what the team menu is. Okay, oh, I can synthesize items. That's what I do. Okay. Ooh. Man, there sure is a lot of things required for this. What does Moogle level give me more things to size? Okay, so I can make lightning shards from blazing shards. Okay, so I can just do a little circle where I can transmute them. And it doesn't give me a lot of XP to do so either, so it's clearly you're only supposed to do it when you actually need to. Okay, let's do a little test real quick. Okay, no, it does not. I was checking if it marked which things you've done. Looks like you can level them up to 8. Okay, but yeah, I was just checking if it marked which of these you've done. Since it doesn't, I probably won't be making any of these unless I actually want to use them. Which means I get to focus over here. Because this is the stuff that matters. Music stage keys, the card icons, whatever those happen to be useful for. I don't know, maybe. And collector's cards. Music stage settings. Oh, okay, I can change the volume of things. Okay. Interesting. Guest characters. The heck does that mean? Ah, to correct for lag, huh? Well, I haven't noticed any yet, but I'm not necessarily sure I will. Okay, so I can have different teams. Do they have different levels, the different teams? But yeah, I have to unlock them in World Tour. Well, let's just keep going for right now. You know? Gotta unlock things. There haven't been any scenes yet, so. Okay, missed 30 times or fewer. Got it. Is that what level it is? I mean, obviously it's difficulty too, but is it also a stat thing? Also, let me go back over here. Okay. Well, it looks like they have separate clears, so I'm gonna test something. If I play this one on standard. Which I'm doing on standard in case the level thing is actually stats that matter somehow. I don't know how they would, but in case they do. They've given me stats, I'm sure they matter in some fashion. No idea how much I listened to this music as a child. But let's just say I was really, really good at the Wakka fight after all that grinding. Every once in a while I press a button too early. Almost all these misses are early presses. Except for that one. That one was a late press. I accidentally hit circle instead of the attack button. Whoops. At least the music is real good. So, funny thing, I actually, and oftentimes in rhythm games, I find the medium difficulty to be a lot easier than the lowest difficulty sometimes. Because lowest difficulty is usually very distant from the music, so you can't just get to the rhythm and hit to the beat. Whereas middle ones are usually, like, pretty close to the beat. Maybe sometime I'll see if I can actually, like, hard get excellent on one of these, but not today. Anyway, so I did that. And I got a collector's card, whatever those are for. We'll return to World Tour, and it looks like there's a scene.
Cool. Led by a mysterious voice, Sora stepped through the door that marked the start of his journey.
Okay. Yeah, that's
Sora,
true.
Sora, Riku, and I wanted to see the world beyond our island.
Also true.
One day, Sora came face to face with a man from another world.
Say one day, but this was like 2 days later.
Meanwhile, Donald and Goofy received a letter from Mickey asking them to find the holder of a certain key.
It would have made more sense to say a few days later rather than one day, because one day implies some like larger passage of time there. That was a period of 3 days that you spend on Destiny Island from them. I guess technically they were already talking about building the raft before that. Okay, I got some material. Okay, so I get memories. I have materials for clearing all the songs in the world. Good to know. Good to know. Okay, I did a feat. And I got a trophy. Okay, I probably could have apparently just read the... Also, this is progress through World Tour, but it doesn't say how far to progress through. Also, it looks like... Okay, I see. Star colors based off section. So that's how it makes sure that you do the section that you're in, rather than just coasting through off a bunch of stars that you had from earlier. Each of these only has one Melody of Fate and Melody of Destruction. So one of these represents Sora, I bet, and the other represents Riku? Interesting, I can see which ones have a scene attached to them. This one does. Alright, so... Yeah, Darkened World, whatever that means. Yeah, let's just go! Oh wait, that reminds me. I should check the memory as items. I need 24 more Lucid Gems. Yeah, okay. So I'll just build those memory dives as I get the materials for them. I'm not gonna worry about them outside of that. Because that's not realistic. Okay, let's keep on going. Okay, we got the boss fight at the end of Destiny Islands. At least, I'm assuming that's what this is supposed to represent. Considering the, you know, destroyed island and all. I'll just stay up here, you know? Why land, right? Easy. Did I select the difficulty? I feel like... Oh, I forgot to actually... What I was going to do was check to see if completing things on, I did it dumb. The two buttons that I hit were, L1 and R1, forgetting that that's a, oops. Easy. A little too early there. Funny that I was close enough to being good on that one that despite me pressing them crack at the same time, one was good and the other wasn't. That's kind of funny. okay, easy. See, like, look. We just go through, and it's a good time. Like, look at how good of a time this is. We just chill our way through. I had some misclicks there, obviously. Yeah, that was the more complicated what's in front of you gets, the harder it is to see what it's actually gonna ask you to do. Let me put it this way, on a second pass, my score is much better from the demo, is what I learned. Because again, they emphasize the optics rather than clarity. Like, they're emphasizing it looking good more than clarity. Which is fine, like, that's understandable. It just makes the first time through a little rough.
One fateful night, darkness consumed Destiny Islands. As Riku disappeared into the darkness, my heart managed to escape to safety inside Sora. The darkness overwhelmed Sora, and he awoke in an unfamiliar town.
Yep, that is definitely what happened. She is correct. That is explicitly exactly how that happened. Exactly how that worked. See, the unfortunate thing is that if there is any lore drops in this, they're probably not going to be until way, 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 way back here. You know, they're going to be somewhere way at the back, you know? Like, that's where any lore drops are going to be, because this front part's pretty well established by other games at this point. Although I'm surprised I guess we're telling the story from Kairi's point of view, so starting here makes sense. Anyway, so what I wanted to check was if I go over to this. Okay, yeah, so it doesn't count the other ones as cleared, and being the completionist I am, I know I'll eventually want to come back and at least clear songs on every difficulty, so I'll just make myself look better and do this entire first run on beginner, yeah? You know? You know, make things a little easier for myself. But okay, so let's go here. Easy. Okay, this is the before the island is destroyed when Sora's wandering around on it music. I understand now. I wonder if Night of Fate is the actual, like, original title they gave this song. Let's ignore the fact that I somehow managed to miss one on beginner, yeah. I blame not being used to the controls. That's definitely the answer. And that answer will definitely not be stale in 20 hours or so when I am close to beating the game. Assuming that I can even do that in 20 hours. Actually, that's a good question. How many songs are there? That's actually a pretty decent measurement of how long this is gonna take, is just look at the amount of songs and how long they are. I just realized that, yeah, you could have solidly made a minimum length guess for this entire game before it even released. like a minimum 100%. Probably means that no one's gonna 100% speedrun this game, because that's really just a question of can you pass every level on first try. That's all it requires. And that's just not as interesting. Oh boy, I did it. It's a miracle that I didn't accidentally miss one of the shadow enemies, considering that I did miss enemies. But hey, I definitely plan to get those stars. Just like that. Anyway, so I got a summoning star, whatever that does. I honestly have no idea. But I sure did get it, though. Sure did get it. So I can get a bunch of blazing shards. That. Clear the nearest darkened world. Okay. Oh, these are boss fights. That's what the darkened worlds are. They're all like fights, and then there's the exploration ones. Okay, so clear. Oh, so they're gonna require me to do it on. So I can just summon Mickey. Good to know. But yeah, so they're gonna make me like this is what I mean by normals are often easier, because you can just hit right to the beat. Like, I did that entirely without even looking at the screen. Other than enough to know how many enemies there were, like, to know what button I needed to press. Other than that, I wasn't paying attention to where things were at all. That was just me hitting to the beat. Wrong button. After a few hours of gameplay, I won't make silly mistakes like pressing triangle when I meant to press X and things like that. Like right there where I hit a button instead of triangle. I just realized that if my computer has the glitch it occasionally has where my audio gets desynced all of a sudden, I am going to be in dire straits all of a sudden. I like how that third button press was a little slower than the other two, because I almost only hit two buttons. Whoops. Anyway, but yeah, so this is pretty cool so far. Oh, a treasure chest? Those are a thing. That's cool. What'd I get in the treasure chest? What are the conditions for a treasure chest? Are there specific conditions? Also, there's apparently a whole section of the song. I got no excellence. Whoops. Oopsie. Okay, so we have some cool things. And I can now select that. Oof. All star targets with a rating of excellent or better. I only got 55%. Yeah, that's not happening. Also not sure what it means by star targets. Oh well. You know what? Yeah, we'll just keep playing on standard. It's fine. Honestly, it is easier to play on standard than beginner, because like I said, I can just hit to the beat. Also, so that's the star ones, okay. I didn't even notice them before. I just like to say that I finally have an excuse to sing along. Like, it's no longer weird for me to hum along because it's a rhythm game. And I had to resist humming along in all the Kingdom Hearts videos. I really like the Kingdom Hearts music, and unlike a lot of other games where I'll be like, oh man, this is good music, but I haven't played the game enough to know the music. In Kingdom Hearts, I do know the music. I know all of it. Like, I could hum along to almost every song in every Kingdom Hearts game. So, just expect that there's going to be random times where I start humming along, because I will probably do it without thinking about it, and I have no reason to hold myself back, like I did when recording the games normally. Which, as of recording this, I've only recorded Kingdom Hearts 1, but there's a good chance that before this goes live, I do some of the other games. Not sure what happened there, but like, all of that was a little late. I hit R1 instead of triangle. You know, that's gonna happen. Until I get more used to the controls, that's just gonna happen randomly. Glide around. Whee! Oh look, a treasure chest. Well, yes, I would like a treasure chest. Why, thank you. Just build up those synthesis materials. I'm just slowly building up my number of lucid gems and my level, although I'm still not really sure what level does for me, honestly. Like, what do stats do for me in this game? I don't know. Is there a special type of song where stats make more sense as a thing to have? Because, I'll be honest, right now, they don't really seem to matter. Like, they're going up as I get stronger, and I guess HP matters. But, I have 30 of something, apparently. Oh, Lucid Shards. Yeah, of course I have 30 Lucid Shards. Anyway, back to, progression next episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.